Inner Traditions Audio presents DMT Entity Encounters, Dialogues of the Spirit Molecule, with Ralph Metzner, Chris Bache, Jeffrey Kripal, Whitley Strieber, Angela Voss, and others. Edited by David Luke and Rory Spowers. Read by Raul Vallenilla and Elizabeth Pimentel. The following presentations were recorded in the summer of 2017. Rather than re-record the presentations to match our edited printed product, we have chosen to present these talks to you with their original wording and flavored retained. We hope you enjoy this format and feel as if you were in the room with these great thinkers and experts. Discussion questions were re-recorded by professional narrators for clarity. Original replies from each presenter were retained to the greatest extent possible.
Foreword. About the Exploring Entheogenic Entity Encounters Symposium. By Rory Spowers and David Luke. Rory Spowers, curator and coordinator of the symposium, is an ecological writer, campaigner, and filmmaker who moved from Mid Wales to Sri Lanka in 2004 and has been living in Ibiza since 2012, where he first went to work with BBC presenter Bruce Parry on the feature film Quest. In 2002, Rory founded the Web of Hope, a UK charity and ecological education resource highlighting role models for sustainability, social justice, and positive change, now part of Sustainopedia. Most recently, he has been working with Mangu TV, promoting documentary films such as Neurons to Nirvana, Understanding Psychedelic Medicines. He is the creative director for the Tyringham Project. David Luke, PhD, moderator and curator of the symposium, is associate professor of psychology at the University of Greenwich, where he has been teaching an undergraduate course on the psychology of exceptional human experience since 2009, and he is also honorary senior lecturer at the Center for Psychedelic Research, Imperial College. His research focuses on transpersonal experiences, anomalous phenomena, and altered states of consciousness, especially via psychedelics, having published more than 100 academic papers in this area, including 10 books. He directs the Ecology, Cosmos, and Consciousness Salon at the Institute of Ecotechnics, London, and is a co-founder and director of Breaking Convention, International Conference on Psychedelic Consciousness. In the early summer of 2017, 11 of the world's leading luminaries, noted for exploring the mysteries of encounter experiences, such as those arising spontaneously or through spiritual practice, or from potent psychedelic compounds such as dimethyltryptamine, DMT, and lysergic acid diethylamide, LSD, gathered, along with a number of multidisciplinary discussants, in the United Kingdom at Tyringham Hall, the spectacular home of Anton Bilton, patron of consciousness research projects. Over 4 days, these open-minded explorers discussed the notion of encounters with apparently discarnate entities. DMT Entity Encounters, the follow-up book to DMT Dialogues, which covered the first meeting on this subject, the Entheogenic Plant Sentience Symposium at Tyringham Hall in 2015, continues to give a potent distillation of the exchange of ideas among these leading thinkers from around the world, experts in anthropology, clinical psychology, psychedelic psychotherapy, neuroscience, physics, cosmology, theology, philosophy, the study of religions and esotericism, and personal encounters with seemingly otherworldly beings. Presenters included Luis Luna, Michael Winkelman, Ralph Metzner, Chris Timmermann, William Richards, Whitley Strieber, Angela Voss, Bernard Carr, Chris Bache, Jeffrey Kripal, and Daniel Pinchbeck. Giancarlo Canavesio, John A. Chavez, Anton Bilton, Rory Spowers, David Luke, Karina Cooper, Vimal Darpin, Aide Frecska, Guy Harriman, Dennis McKenna, Linda Patchen, Jerry Patchen, Judith Way, and Patrick Vernon participated in discussions alongside the invited speakers. This edited collection of presentations and discussions describes a wide spectrum of perspectives that have arisen within this field, ranging from indigenous Amazonian wisdom regarding such entity encounters alongside that of alien abductees and the Neoplatonists, to theories around innate mental modules and the incorporation of insights from neurobiological research and DMT brain imaging studies. What has emerged from the second extraordinary meeting of minds is no less seismic in its implications than that of the first meeting. These encounter experiences have accompanied humans for millennia and continue to ruffle the edges of what we assume to be reality, and despite our expertise from so many domains of intellectual pursuit, their true identity remains mysterious. Indeed, we are reminded once again of the inscription in the Theosophical Temple of Music in the garden at Tyringham Hall. In quest of truth, seek truth, but remember that behind all the new knowledge, the fundamental issues of life will remain veiled. Through staging the initial symposium in 2015, the Tyringham Initiative was born, a world-class think tank, or modern mystery school, that believes the synthesis of science and spirit, and even direct experience of the divine, to be fundamental to reshaping our worldview. At a time when multiple scientific disciplines, from quantum physics to neuroscience, are converging on the core truth and mystic vision of the perennial philosophy that consciousness may indeed be primary and not secondary to matter, the role played by a compound such as DMT seems ever more crucial to explore. We would like to thank the following individuals for their help with the symposium: Max Baring, Thomas Worthenson, and Giancarlo Canavesio for documenting it all on film, Lisa Lafag for helping smooth the way, Maya Bracknell Watson, Pascal Michael, and Amy Tolan for the transcription of the talks and discussions, and all the staff of the Tyringham Initiative for looking after us. Preface. Symposium Objectives by David Luke. David Luke's biography was given previously. DMT is a simple organic molecule present in an extremely wide range of animals and probably all plants, though curiously not fungus, which in true mycelial style has its own version, 4-HO-DMT. That DMT is also naturally occurring in humans is no doubt part of why it is so often experientially considered to be the strongest and strangest of all psychedelics, delivering half of all high-dose users to new yet curiously familiar alien worlds where sentient non-human beings await to greet them. Welcome back, we missed you. Few experiencing these phenomena report anything less than a world seemingly more real than this one. Science explores, charts, navigates, discovers, and increasingly comprehends the physical world both macro and micro. It pushes the limits of outer space, yet is asleep at the wheel of our outward thrusting vehicle, giving scant regard to mapping inner space, which is both within the universe and our personal container of it. And yet, what could be a more important scientific research question in a materialistic world than locating, verifying, and communicating with beings apparently far more intelligent and knowledgeable than we are? given that $100 million was recently provided to boost the search for extraterrestrial intelligence research project, also known as SETI, wouldn't we expect any project that already has half its researchers reporting positive communications equally, if not more worthy of investigation? But where are all the research grants, the scientific papers, the scientists and experts? Ah, there you are. All 10 of you. Welcome back. We missed you. The question of DMT beings, of plant sentience, of interspecies communication, of discarnate consciousness, of perhaps even dialoguing with the divine, these are surely some of the most important of all research questions. They cut to the heart of the nature of reality itself. The precise tool for this research has been available for more than 50 years, but the Academy has left it in the pencil jar in the Secretary's office, hiding in plain sight. So what steps should be made on our road to discovery? What is the role of DMT in plant-human coevolution, and what is its origin? Can we verify this other world and these other beings? Is the DMT world just delusional? Is our imagination more tricksy and infinite than we give it credit for? Or are these beings somehow real? If real, then what are their intentions? And what is our relationship to them? Is it time to establish an interdimensional embassy? Or to barricade our minds against the other? Or are we just finding a new way to dialogue with our higher self? In any case, what can be learned from the beings and from DMT and our study of it, anthropologically, culturally, psychologically, linguistically, pharmacologically, medically, evolutionarily, heuristically, and epistemologically? Or does all this exploration just generate more questions than answers, a chimeric rabbit hole, more labyrinthine than our crenulated brain will allow us to fathom, and more obscure than dark matter? Maybe we will find out.
Introduction: The Marrying of Science and Spirituality by Anton Bilton. Anton Bilton, host of the symposium, is an economics graduate from the City University in London. He was a founder of the Raven Group, and has also been a founder and director of three other companies that have floated on the London Stock Exchange's alternative investment market. He is currently executive deputy chairman of Raven Russia Limited. Outside of his working environment, Anton's principal interest is altered states of consciousness and entheogenic plant.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.